Pleased to be joined by Joaquin Gage. As head coach Jay Woodcroft said post-game, hockey is a game of 60 minutes and not 50. And after getting out to a start that they were looking for by scoring twice in the opening 21 minutes, the Oilers simply let their foot off the gas pedal, allowing four goals in a span of 11 minutes and 4 seconds en route to a 5-2 loss.
Yeah, Tony, and we've seen this before with the Oilers earlier on. It seemed like 5-6 minutes where they would have that lapse and the other team would take advantage of them. And even Coach Woodcroft recognizing that, how did he put it, the energy wasn't there on the bench or on the ice, taking that timeout after the Kraken tied it up 2-2, and still Oilers couldn't find that, get back what they had in that first period. So hard once you lose that momentum to try to get it back, especially with a Kraken team that was played more of a Seattle Kraken structured game.
And speaking of the Kraken, we talked about it in the Oilers Plus Live pregame show that coming into tonight, they were the only team in the National Hockey League to have 13 players scoring more than 15 points, and that was certainly on display tonight with 5 different goal scorers.
Yeah, and I said, like, it's funny when you watch the Kraken play, they just, all the lines seem the same from their top line to their fourth line. It's, they don't have any differences. They all play a structured, hard-nosed game, and it's I think the Oilers can kind of look at that and draw some of the comparisons to that team, because the Oilers are so skilled. If they can match the work ethic of a team like Seattle, their skill would eventually take over, and I don't think Seattle would be able to match it. But again, they bring that every single night, and that's why they're in a playoff position.
Now, Seattle did beat Stuart Skinner 4 times in the 35 minutes and 48 seconds of ice time he saw before getting yanked. But it's hard to blame number 74 for at least 3 of those goals. Yes, maybe he wanted the one rebound back, but it's the attention to detail that hurt the Oilers.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to blame Stuart Skinner for those first 3. I believe there's battles lost in front of him on each of those goals, and you saw just the defensive structure of the Oilers just kind of fall apart at certain points. But silver lining, Jack Campbell gets back into the net. As a goalie, you got to take advantage of that. Maybe it's a spark that can light you up. Came in, wasn't busy, but just getting a few more reps. I look to him to... I'm sure he'll probably start next game, give him the opportunity to come back, and hopefully he can give Stuart Skinner a little bit of rest and get his game going and have 2 solid goalies going into the playoffs.
Well, it's certainly not the start that the Oilers were looking for in 2023, beginning the new year with a loss, their 5th straight loss here at Rogers Place, as their home record falls to 9-11-1, but they have an opportunity to get back in the win column when they host the New York Islanders on Thursday night.